cloud in the sky, except for that one huge cloud that covers the whole sky. Friends, this is not how I envisioned Camp Wapiti would be this year. I think that this cloudy day is a great way to express, what's going on? I figured that at this time we would be in the middle of our first week of camp. And it's just not as we expected. If there was a parade, you could say that it's been rained on. And it's Canada Day, and so even if there was a parade today, and there's not, there's a reverse parade happening today, but it would be literally raining on the parade. Now, when things don't go as planned, and you don't have all the right conditions to do all the things that you hoped or expected for, when things change, when a wrench gets thrown into your plans, or it just isn't what you thought, and you have to make do with something different. No, you got a couple options. First option is you can stick your head kind of down and mope around and say, oh shoot, this sucks. Or you can say, well, we'll just forget about it. Or you can look up at the cloudy sky and say, rain, bring it on. And that's what we're doing this year with Camp Wapiti. Come rain or sun, come coronavirus or perfect health, or just regular health, we are going to keep moving forward. And the way that we're doing that this year is with Camp Wapiti Live and the Camp Wapiti Show. Now, Camp Wapiti Live was going to be on Zoom, but I think we may be doing some in-person greetings, because we can at least do that now. Some in-person meetings and events for junior high and up. Camp Wapiti Show is for all ages, geared a little bit more toward elementary kids. And that show is airing right now. In fact, you're watching it. Friends, we've got a couple weeks ahead of us of Camp Wapiti content coming your way. This is episode one of the Camp Wapiti Show.
Please take me to the place I want to be. Camp Wapiti is the place I want to be. Come down with me to the place we want to be. With all that said, it's the greatest place in all the land. And we'll play all day, and we'll sing all night, and we'll sleep real good till morning light. And we'll do it all together, cause we're alright, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Come on, come join the fun. We've only just begun. Camp to camp, there's a place for everyone. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'll take you to the place where I feel God's love shine down like the sun from up above. Where everyone is smiling and having fun, and we sing about Jesus and all he's done. You and for me and for everyone.
Years of Camp Wapiti. 50 years. That was a while ago now. We are well back past 50 years at this point. This is the first year that camp has looked like this. Really appreciate you joining us for the Camp Wapiti Show. It's going to be a little bit different. But I want you to know there's ways for you to be involved right out the gate. First thing that I announced last Sunday was that everyone who sent me a 10 to 20 second clip of what camp means to them, everyone who sends those clips in, for every clip we get, that's $10 thanks to some generous sponsors, $10 for camp. We are going to use that money to help top up our building funds because we would really like to do some upgrades in our kitchen. We'd really like to get some other building stuff going on down there in the dining hall area. And yeah, so not only though are you going to get, by sending those clips in, are you going to get $10 to camp. That's the easiest $10 we're ever going to get, I'm sure. But everyone who sends me those clips, we're going to put you into a draw for some camp merch, because as you can see, we have a healthy stock that we would just love to share with you guys. So that's how you do it. Send me those clips. I know that we said that Wednesday was going to be the deadline to get these clips to us, but I talked with both of our anonymous sponsors and both of them said we would really love to give camp a lot of money. So please extend it for one more week. So the deadline, the new deadline to send us your video clips is next week, Wednesday, 10 o'clock. I keep looking at the wrong side of the camera. $10 per video. Send them to me before next Wednesday at lunch. So you could be making your video right now, and that'd be really, really great. We would love to get those funds. So first thing we're going to do to kick off our show, now that I've made that announcement, by the way, we already have about $100 raised for camp. $100 just from sending in some video clips. So send your clips in, please. Let's get like 200, 300, 500. Let's get $1,000 for camp. That would be unreal. We would love to do that. So before we go any further, I had an awesome crew of people come help me out last week on Saturday, getting our improv and our skits ready. So we have an awesome amount of content for you guys today. Super excited about that. Not only for today, but for all the weeks to come. So huge shout out to our volunteers who helped out with some of our improv and some of our sketches that we've got going for you guys. We're gonna kick it off with one of the Camp Wapiti favorites. This is called Ya Putcha.
Chief, is it time for Ya Putcha?
No.
Chief, is it time for Ya Putcha?
Chief, it's time for your putcha.
Yes. You put your right hand in, you put your right hand out, you put your right hand in, and you shake it all about. That's what it's all about.
Yeah! Woo! That was fantastic. Thanks, guys. We've got another improv sketch for you that's was done online a little bit earlier. Nature Boy put it together. Really excited to get that and show you that. In the meantime, though, I want to share two of the videos that we received so far already from campers who are telling us what camp means to them. Just a reminder to send those clips in. So here's those two clips that we got from campers earlier this week.
I love Camp Wapiti because I can make new friends and playing games. And I love the Fen Police.
I love Camp Wapiti because I get to go out and have fun for a week and go hang out with my friends and meet new people and connect with God and nature.
Well, thanks, Katarina and Ben. That was really awesome to get those videos. And shh, about the Fen Police. We don't want any spoilers for what's yet to come, okay? Now, that was $20 for camp, just like that, bang, bang. How many more videos can we get? Can we get 10, 20, 30, 50, 100 videos or more? Tell your friends, tell everybody, please send us those videos. Our donors, our sponsors are very interested in us doing well here. So let's get some. This is a great time to introduce my good friend. I won't say his name, many of you will know him. He'll introduce himself actually, but he's got an object lesson for us that's gonna segue really well into our verse for today. We're big about God, we're big about the Bible at Camp Wapiti, we're big about Jesus, we're big about life, and life is all about trusting God. Here's an awesome little object lesson for my good friend that's gonna help us, yeah, visualize what that could look like.
Hi, my name's John. Some of you might know me as Mr. John. Some of you might know me as Dad. Well, that's probably just my three kids, but you can call me whatever you want as long as you listen to what we're gonna do today. Because today we're gonna talk about what people rely on, what they put their trust in. Now there's lots of things people can put their trust in. So let's think for a second. What do people put their trust in? What do you think? Oh, I can't hear you because you're on the other side of the TV screen, but probably some of the things you were saying were money or possessions, things they have, or maybe it's their family or their friends, or maybe it's cars, motorcycles, or, you know, some of their houses or whatever it may be. That's what people rely on. In the Bible, it says in Psalm 20, verse 7, it says, "Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God." There's a great song about this. It goes, "Some trust in chariots, we trust in the name of the Lord our God. Some trust in horses, we trust in the name of the Lord our God. We trust in the name of the Lord our God." I'm not here to sing the song.
Phew! Well, that's a relief.
You know, I'm here to show you something amazing that will hopefully teach you about the incredible truth from God's Word, the Bible. Let's say that this cup represents God. And this egg represents us. Just a normal egg, just a normal person, you and me. So what happens in life when there's lots of troubles, when we're not sure what's going on, when we don't know where to trust? Can we still trust that God is going to take care of us and catch us and keep us safe? There's lots of things that can come up in life that scare us, that are unknown. We don't know what's happening. Is God going to take care of us? Yes, he is! Fantastic! Now, I know you're saying, "Sure, that's great, Mr. John. You know, it's so great when God takes care of us, when we're doing great, and when life's going well, it can be kind of easy to trust God, right? But what about if things start to get really tricky? You know, what about if you have some major things going on in your life? Maybe COVID-19 comes up, right? And everything has changed, and you can't do what you're normally doing, and you can't go to school, and you can't see your friends. What about then? Can we still trust God? You know, what about if you're getting picked on at school? What about if someone you love, someone you trust, lets you down? Can you still trust that God is going to look after you and take care of you? It can be hard, for sure, because there's lots of stuff that comes up in life that we're not sure. Can we still trust God? But God says, fear not, I will take care of you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Trust God this week.
Some trust in chariots. We trust in the name of the Lord our God. Some trust in horses. We trust in the name of the Lord our God. We trust in the name of the Lord our God. We trust in the name of the Lord our God. His love never fails. His name will always prevail. We trust in the name of the Lord our God.
Thanks, John, for that awesome object lesson. And thanks, God, for being a God that we can trust. Absolutely, 100%. It's okay, guys. We can always rest knowing that God is in control. He loves us, even in the worst and weirdest of times. And thanks, John, for that awesome object lesson. Really appreciated that. Kids, if you want to try that at home, make sure you talk to your parents first. And I would also suggest stocking up on eggs, because I don't think, well, I mean, maybe you're good, but you might need to try it a couple times. Well, we got a song for you today. Just one. Kind of weird. Usually we do lots of songs at camp, but just one. It's a good one, though. I think you'll really like it. So take it away, Caleb. What? Me? Yeah, I'm doing the song today. Enjoy this song. Sing it lots this week, and we'll give you more songs next week. This is a song about being a Christian, about spelling, and about living forever. Three really important things. When Jesus died on the cross, he took our sin away. And because he took our sin away, God is able to forgive our sins. And when God forgives our sins, when we trust in him, well, that means that we will live forever with him. That is the best news the world has ever known. It's called the gospel. Christ died, we live. It's amazing. That's why we trust him. And that's the promise that God makes to us. So we're going to sing this song now. It's called I Am a Sea. Goes a little like this. Sea. Let's spell it together. I am a sea. I am a C-H. I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N. And I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T. And I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. That spells I am a Christian. And I have Christ in my heart, so I will live eternally. Jesus is alive within us. God is alive within us, and God lives forever. Woohoo! So will we. But it goes a little bit faster. I am a C. I am a C-H. I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N. And I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T. And I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. I am a C. I am a C-H, I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, and I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T, and I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. I am a C, I am a C-H, I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, and I have C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T, and I will L-I-V-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. I am a C. I am a C-H. I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-N. And I am C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T. And I will L-I-V-E-D-E-R-N-A-L. I am a C-H. I am a C-H-R-I-S-T-I-N. And I am C-H-R-I-S-T in my H-E-A-R-T. And I will L-I-V-E-D-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y. Faster? Oh, faster, you say. Well, see what we can do. Who? I am a C. I'm C-H. C-H-R-S-T-I-N. I'm C-H-R-S-T-I-N-H-R-T-O-L-L-E-R-N-A-Y. That's pretty fast. Faster? I am a C-C-H-C-H-R-S-T-I-N-C-H-R-S-T-I-N-H-R-T-O-L-L-E-R-N-A-Y. What? You want me to go even faster than that? That was really fast, don't you know? Oh. I am a C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C-C- Don't. What? Oh. The lightning round? Well, if that's what you want, here it is! There it is. Sing that song, Locks, this week, guys. Sing it at home every day. That's your challenge. Be thankful to God for what he's done. You can trust him and stay focused on him through singing that song. And if you sing it really, kids, if you sing it loud in the morning, early in the morning, it'll be just like at camp. Just like wake-up time. We should probably get some flagpole stuff in here. Speaking of wake-up times, that's for future episodes. Anyway, if you have any comments about what you've seen today, what you'd like to see, feel free to share it with me. Last thing I'm going to leave you guys with is our improv, or our second little improv piece from Nature Boy, aka David Wood. He put this together. This is a really, really fun thing. I had a lot of fun listening to it. I think it's going to be a good laugh for you. So I'm going to let him explain what's going on. And we're going to see you guys next week with another episode of Camp Wapiti Show. Peace out, guys.
Welcome to improv. Improv is the part of the night where your counselors, kitchen help, other campers, in fact, anyone can come up and play all sorts of fun and silly games. Today, the game that we're going to be playing is called Short Story Telephone. In it, someone, me in this case, will record themselves telling a beautiful and eloquent tale with all sorts of fun details. But then they'll send that recording to a friend, and that friend can only watch that video one time and then must tell back that beautiful and eloquent tale with all sorts of details as best they can remember. And then that friend will send it to another person, and that'll repeat a few times, and eventually the story will sound quite different, and hopefully the ride along will be very fun. Our tale begins as Milton the Wise exits his home full of energy and ready for what the day has in store. Today, Milton has no plans and simply starts walking down the road to the left. As he walks along at a casual pace, Milton comes across a part of the forest that he is unfamiliar with, and undaunted, he continues deeper into these strange new woods. Now, in this part of the forest, there dwells an enormous beast called the Zoggerblop, a terrible monster that feeds on people and freshly baked pastries. The Zoggerblop was very hungry today, and for the past week had been looking for someone to devour. Thus, he was very happy when he and our hero's path crossed. Milton, being very wise, said, "Hello, and who might you be?" For he wondered if the creature before him was merely unpleasant in appearance and not in spirit. The Zoggerblop, who was about to leap upon his dinner, was entirely caught off guard by this pleasant remark, and was compelled to state the following.
I'm the Zoggerblop," said the very confused monster,
while wondering why he wasn't yet chewing on his entree's skull. "It is wonderful to meet you, Zoggerblop. My name is Milton."
"Nice to meet you, Milton," said the Zoggerblop.
who was getting hungrier still, his mouth moving with a curious lack of food in it. "Can you tell me?" was all Milton could say before the Zoggerblop had regained his senses and leapt at Milton and swallowed him whole. Thus ends Milton's story, but do not fret, for the Zoggerblop never ate another human again, so as to avoid engaging in another conversation. And that is how Milton, however inadvertently, saved a good portion of mankind from the Zoggerblop.
Our story begins with Milton the Wise leaving his home fresh and full of energy, not sure what he would do, but sure he would love it. He leaves his house and he goes to the left. He doesn't have any plans, but there's a forest there, so he thinks, why not go there? And then he comes across a terrible, ugly creature named the Zoggerbloth. And what he didn't know is that the Zoggerbloth loves to eat people and freshly baked pastries. But Milton the Wise is a very kind and he doesn't suspect any meanness off the bat. He thinks maybe that the Zoggerbloth is just really mean-looking and generally nice otherwise. So he says, "Oh, hello, how are you doing?" And the Zoggerbloth is very startled that someone is talking to him instead of it being immediately eaten. So he said, I'm good. Very confused. And Milton says, "Oh, well, that's very nice. Isn't it a fine day?" But then he's cut off and he can't finish his thought because the Zoggerbloth has regained his wits and he has swallowed Milton whole. But this was not all for naught. That was a mosquito. It's camp. Milton was eaten, but if not for his bravery, then bad things would happen. Instead, the Zoggerbloth never ate another human again because he was afraid of another awkward conversation like that. The end.
Once upon a time, Milton the Wise went on a journey. On this journey, he crossed a bridge and went into a forest and he took a left. And as he was walking to the left, he came across the Zoggerbloth. And the Zoggerbloth said, and Milton said, "I'm fine, how are you?" And the Zoggerbloth, and Milton the Wise realized that the Zoggerbloth was ate people and fine pastries, but the Zoggerbloth didn't eat him. And they had this awkward conversation. Nom, nom, nom. And Milton the Wise said, "That's okay. I'll be okay because he's sick or something. He's not going to eat me." But then the Zoggerbloth regained his wits and ate Milton the Wise. But all was not for naught. The Zoggerbloth never ate another human being again because he was afraid of having another awkward conversation like the one he had with Milton the Wise. The end.
Once upon a time, there was a man named Milton the Wise. Milton the Wise went on a journey and went across a bridge and to the left. And on the left, he found a Zargothob. The Zargothob went, "Rawr, rawr, rawr, rawr." Milton Wise said, "I am well. How are you?" But little did Milton know that the Zargothob ate people and fine pastries. But he figured the Zargothob was sick, so it would not eat him. So Milton went on his journey. The Zargothob figured he would never eat people again because Milton the Wise made such an embarrassment of him. The end.
Once upon a time, there was a man named Milton the Wise. Milton the Wise went on a journey, and he crossed a bridge and went to the left. He found a creature called Zermatherb. And Zermatherb said, meow, meow, meow. And so Milton the Wise said, how are you? Little did Milton know that this creature ate people and pastries. But because he thought the creature was sick, he did not think he'd get eaten. And so he went on his way, and the creature, the Zermatherb, decided it would no longer eat people because Milton the Wise was very embarrassing. The end.
So, once upon a time, there was a person named Milton the Wise who went on a journey. He went across a bridge, turned left at the bridge, found a thing called a Zermather, and it said mew mew mew, and the Zermather ate people and pastries, and because he was embarrassed by this, he stopped eating people and pastries. The end.
Once upon a time, there was a person named Herman the Wise, and he liked to eat people and pastries, but he was ashamed of that, so he quit eating people and pastries and instead went on a journey where he ran into a Minithorpe, and there was more, but I don't remember it.
Hi. So there once upon a time, there was a man named Herman the Wise who didn't seem very wise because he had this strange fetish where he liked to eat people wrapped in pastries. And he was rather ashamed of this fact and didn't want it to be well known. So he decided to go on an adventure to Mexico where he could escape from everybody who knew that he liked people in pastries and start a new life. And that is the story of Herman the Wise.
That was a good one. I laughed so hard when the first time I saw that. Couldn't believe they changed the name of the monster so many times. And how on earth did we get to Mexico? That's crazy. Anyway, thanks for doing that, David. That was awesome. Hope you guys enjoyed the Camp Wapiti show. Look forward to seeing you next week. Bye.